这支 lab has taken apart the compact version of Apple 35W dual USB-C charger. And just as we mentioned, Apple announced two 35W chargers at WWDC 22. So we got the other 35W charger, which adopts the traditional design. Let me show you what it looks like inside. First, the pure white packaging adopts the same design. We can see two USB-C ports stand side by side.Open the box, here are some documents. Just like the compact 35W charger, there is no cable inside. This charger continues the design of traditional Apple chargers, so you may be familiar with it. But those two USB-C ports are different from other Apple chargers. Unlike the compact 35W charger, the input prongs can be detached. You can easily replace different input prongs. The specs info is on the side, model is A2676,It can support wide range input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, and output of 12 volts, 1.75 amp, 15 volts, 2.33 amp, 9 volts, 3 amp, 5 volts, 3 amp. The maximum power is 35 watts, manufactured by Flextronics Power. The size is about 56 by 56 by 28 millimeter, and the weight is about 115 grams. It's slightly larger than 20 watts charger,Compared to the old 30W charger, the size is almost the same, but it has an additional USB-C port. The PowerZ KM002C shows it only supports PD 3.0, and full fixed PDLs are 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 2.33 Amp, and 20V, 1.75 Amp. The PDL info will change if we test both USB-C ports at the same time. This time, we've also done some tests to check how it works.When we charge two iPads, the power is 16.5 watts respectively. The power will drop to 1 watt, but it won't be disconnected after inserting the second iPhone. Then the power will gradually go back to normal. And the power is around 19 watts and 16 watts respectively. When we charge iPhone and AirPods, the power is 1.7 watts and 26 watts respectively. When we charge iPhone and MacBook, the power is around 16.5 watts respectively.And when we only charge MacBook, the power is 33 watts. It can charge Nintendo Switch, but the TV mode isn't supported. After the brief test, let's take it apart to check what's inside. Firstly, let's use the cutting machine to remove the outer plastic. The internal components are covered with thermal pads for heat dissipation and fixing. And here is the graphite thermal pad for heat dissipation. Take out the PCB module and the ground wire is fixed by a screw. You can replace a 3-prong block to avoid the current leakage or electric shock. The module is divided into AC to DC and secondary step-down parts. Two parts are connected through 4 black wires. Remove all black covers.TreasureLab found it is equipped with a switching power supply circuit and two step-down circuits. The secondary side of the transformer is directly connected to the output PCB. Then the output PCB is responsible for synchronous rectification and step-down. Next, let's introduce all components one by one. The input fuse is protected by a heat shrinkable tube and fixed here. The safety X2 capacitor is under the fuse, 0.1 microfarad.And a common mode choke is next to it, wound with two wires. The input bridge rectifier can convert AC into pulse to DC and comes from light on. Three electrolytic capacitors are from Capexon, 22 microfarad, 400 volts, 66 microfarad in total. The differential mode choke isn't protected by heat shrinkable tube and can convert pulse to DC to pure DC through three electrolytic capacitors.The master control chip is Apple's customized model, marked with APSL-CA01. It is also used in Apple 96W and 30W charger. A MOSFET is from STMicroelectronics. This is a current transformer used for current detection. The primary switch transistor is from AOS and adopts DFN8x8 package, 700 volts, 160 milliohm. Another MOSFET is also from STMicroelectronics. The transformer is wound and insulated with tape. This small capacitor can power the mass control chip 35 volts, 47 microfarad. The small PCB next to the transformer is used for upper voltage feedback. And let's remove this small PCB. A black safety wire capacitor is on the back. And here is the EL1014 optocoupler. Next, let's look at the upper PCB. It's equipped with two secondary step-down circuits, and a piece of copper foil is attached to the shell. Most components and USB-C ports are paired, except for the protocol chip. Flip to the back, we can find a synchronous rectifier, two V-bus switch MOSFETs, two step-down MOSFETs, and two synchronous step-down controllers from left to right. The front synchronous rectifier controller is marked with TEV. The synchronous rectifier is from Infineon and adopts Super S08 package, 150 volts, 9.3 milliohm. The solar capacitor is from Nichicon, 270 microfarad, 25 volts. The protocol chip is also from Infineon, which is fixed by glue. We found it is the same chip used in Apple Compact 35W dual USB-C charger. You can also click the upright corner to check the previous video if you haven't. Two synchronous step-down controllers are from MPS MP9928, used for step-down control of two USB-C ports, respectively. It integrates the half-bridge driver and supports programmable operating frequency. It also has output overvoltage and overheat protection. Two synchronous step-down MOSFETs are from ON Semiconductor, which integrates dual MOSFETs for each. 30 volts, 6.4 to 11.6 milliohm. There are 5 parallel MLCC used for filtering, and two 6R8 alloy inductors are also used for step-down. Those three solid capacitors are from Nichicon FP5K series, 100 microfarad, 25 volts. Two output VBUS MOSFETs are from AOS and adopt DFN 3.3 multiply 3.3 package, 30 volts, 2.3 milliohm. Finally, two USB-C ports are fixed with white plastic and stand side by side. Well, that's all components of this charger. It continues the exterior design of older Apple chargers, but its interior design and architecture are completely different. The PCB module can be divided into two parts, and the AC to DC part can output a fixed voltage. Then, two synchronous step-down circuits can output different voltage according to the devices. The mass control chip is a customized model, same as Apple 96W and 30W. The rest of the components are from famous brands like Infineon, MPS, Lighton, Nichicon, etc. Okay, that's it for today's video. We'll also have more videos about this charger coming soon. Stay tuned, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.